One, two, three. Hello, we're going to get started. Welcome to Sacred Ground. It's just after 11 o'clock. It is raining, and yesterday, I know that the ladies were all out and about with the women's tour of homes. Is there any report on that?
We had a lovely time, and then our potluck, you'll find leftovers from it. But there were 10 of us, and we made 5 different stops, and lots of laughter. We did a Christmas story. It puts us all in good spirit and hope next year. Many more people join us.
I saw pictures and then putting the new art gallery downtown. Kelli showed me that. So, and the next Saturday on the 16th is the Gingerbread Ministry at the Grange. And talk to Marie Mason if you have questions about that. Other things coming up, I know that Rebekah has worked diligently on the bulletin, so please read that. Everything I can think of is in there. We're praying for health. And any updates or prayer requests from anybody?
A few things after we started decorating, we have our
tree
that has big snow on it.
And health and business and all that. So, well, we're going to do some Christmas songs, and there's a few of us in here, so I will light the candles and ask Marie to come up and pray with us. But the first candle, which we lit last week, because this is Advent season, was on hold. And we're going to sing a song on this about the peace of the Lord. So the second candle represents peace.
And so we pray, Lord Jesus, that you would send your peace down. Marie, would you like to come up and pray for us? You have the offering there if you're prepared for it.
Okay, I will. Lord, we lift up the Lord, we come before you in
Jesus'
name. We're very small, but Lord, you are very big.
That's right.
And you're here with us. The big God who can do anything, all things. He just says to me all the time, I'm here to meet all of your needs. I'm with you and I'll never leave you.
Yes.
And Lord, well, all he says, he just wants us to trust him to save us. That doesn't mean just salvation. That means save us in every situation we're in, everything we're going through. Save us, Lord, whatever we're doing, whatever going on. In Jesus' name, Lord, we lift up. Patricia, Lord, that you would help them, Mike and Patty, in their situation, that she can come home, Lord. Lord, you make a way where there doesn't seem to be a way.
Amen, Lord. Amen.
So, Father, in Jesus' name, make a way. We ask in Jesus' name, Lord, for her. In Jesus' name, amen. And Lord, we just ask for your presence, Lord Jesus. Help us to worship you. Make a habitation for you here, Lord, where you can abide with us as we just can send up adoration to you, Father,
yes,
in the mighty name
yes,
of
Lord.
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And I forgot to mention that after today's service, of which Jim will be preaching, Jim Reed will be in the pulpit, and we have a potluck and a business meeting today, so this is the Sunday for that. So please stick around, and if you didn't bring food, I'm sure there's plenty. So let's worship. Yeah. Does Ivy feel like playing? Do you feel like playing the drum? No? Okay. Let's just do it. Let's just do it. So. Send the lifeline to the little lamb. Do you see what I see? Way up in the sky. Mind. to the shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the tree with a voice as big as the sea. As big as the sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know? Do you know what I know?
In your palace for
mighty king,
do you know what I know?
Do you know what I know? A child. Shivers in the cold, let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Said the king to the people everywhere, listen to what I say.
Until
fill us, Emmanuel. We rejoice in you. That's right. God's with us. All right.
Time to give your heart. are God, and one day every knee will bow. Amen. But still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. So come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give.
We are small and we're tiny, and what do we have? Just like the song said, shall we play a song before you? What good do we do before you? We only have two little pennies to give to you, Lord. We only have two little fish and five loaves of bread, but you say, come, just give them to me and I'll take care of it, Lord. So we come as we are to worship you, Lord. We come as we are. We come who we are. And we continue to pray for everyone, Lord, to come to you in spirit and in truth. We pray for everyone, Lord. Father, just dissolve away from us our unforgiveness and our attitudes, Lord. We pray that everywhere that they're lifting up your name this morning, you would bless them, Father. People who don't even know who you are, we ask that you'd bless them, Lord. Draw them to yourselves, Lord. Hallelujah. On El Shaddai, on you Sing songs or whatever we do, Lord, we know that you're with us through the water, through the fire. No matter what comes our way, Lord, you're with us. We celebrate you. Thank you, Jesus. When the music fades and all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's a word that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper with through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've all about you, Jesus. King of endless words, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours. Every single breath, I'll bring you more than a song. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made, when it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it. When it's all about you. Jesus, we take the arrows that you've given us. Lord, we don't want to turn them inward to us, but we want to shoot them out. Just as someone prophetically said, they were shooting from Portland to the Oregon coast. Long time ago, years ago. Heavenly Father, we shoot the arrows out that your spirit would go and you draw all men to yourself. Jesus, we lift up your name above this community like a bright light, like the star of Bethlehem it is. Lord, your name, the blood of Jesus over our community. Father, rid us of poison. Rid us of the poison of the evil one who tries to steal and to kill and destroy. He will try, but he's not going to be successful. Lord, you are successful. You are victorious, and you give us the victory. So we shoot our arrows, even as that drum is playing, into the community, Lord, into homes that are broken, which would be all of us, Lord. We need you, all of us, Lord. Not one of us has attained it, Lord. We're all broken inside. We need you, and we welcome you, Lord, here and in our community, Lord. Every place, in Jesus' name, hallelujah, praise your name, amen, Lord, amen, Lord, amen, Lord, may it be so. That he has removed the poison of unforgiveness from us. Have you ever heard that, that when you have unforgiveness, it's like, you're the one that suffers. So we pray that we would forgive as we have been forgiven much. And again, it's my pleasure to welcome Pastor Jim Reed. And we pray, Lord, your anointing upon us. May we hear the word of the Lord through your servant, Jesus' name. Amen.
Wherever we happen to be, to
Name the name of Jesus. Name above all names. Lord, I ask that you would help me to be settled, to share what you have given me to share this morning. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, first, I'd like to share a little card that we got from some friends that live over in Bend. And I don't have time to share the whole thing, but hopefully I'll be able to read this, because I didn't try it with my glasses at home, and this is interesting. As the lettering is a little smaller. Okay, as we look at our world situation, we are reminded that this world is not our home. We want to spend our days pointing others to our eternal home in heaven with Jesus Christ. God alone knows the number of our days, and we are asked to simply follow Him and live a life that reflects Him. The Bible calls us to be children of God, not adults of God. Business professionals of God are personal growth experts of God. Children grow through learning. And as we follow Christ through life, we will always be learning, taking tests, sometimes failing. A great analogy, and we see it in watching Gunner, who is their grandchild, learn and grow. What a blessing. And they go on to say, we pray that you take some time to reflect and remember how faithful our God is and how He demonstrated His love for us when He sent Jesus to earth, become God in the flesh. Make your celebration be around His love rather than the presence. He truly is the best gift ever, and the reason for the season. Amen. So I'm going to read Hosea 4 through 6. And this is some pretty harsh language, but I believe that part of why our country and our world is in the situation it is because people have rejected the knowledge that we've been given by the Lord. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. That thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children. Man, that is tough. But it's the word of God. Amen. And Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Old Testament, I believe, is just as relevant as the new. All of His word is relevant for now. And we can learn from all of it. And I'd like to share John 17:3 out of the New Testament. With these glasses, things are a little bit interesting. It's like you're looking around in a glass or something here. But in
John 17, verse 3, and this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. Amen. There is only one Savior. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. There's no other way to the Father. John 14, 6. Sanctification is not something you can grow into. Sometimes people say, and I'm sure you can all look around at people throughout your lives. There have been a lot of people who have been Christians for 50 years and you wonder what happened. And I'm not up here to judge anybody or point any fingers. It doesn't matter how long you know Christ, it's how you walk with Him. Sin is a monster and you cannot control it on your own. That's why He said we can't live this life on our own. Amen? How many times do we try to do it though? How many times do we try to get up and, hey, this is a little problem I can handle? And this is where I'd like to use the analogy of a tree stump. Because I've cut a lot of trees down, and I enjoy it. Some trees are more susceptible of shooting sprouts or sprouts up and living again. And that's sort of how our old nature is like. It's dead, you killed it. But it's just under the surface. Can you always handle your anger? Can you always handle your lust? Can you always handle everything that comes at you? Some days are probably better than others, amen? And I believe that the Lord allows things to come into our life at times to just see where we are, because I'm not your judge, hallelujah. You're not my judge. But He tells us to examine ourselves. He's the judge, amen? And He said, I died on the cross. I shed my blood. I was buried. I rose again from the dead. I purchased you. I love you so much that I came here and did this. But I didn't die and rise again from the dead for you to just stay in your old life or fall back into sin. I came here for you to have new life and to be holy. It takes a lot of work to be holy. And it's not something that we can take credit for. Amen? But He tells us, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. So there is some hard work for us to do. Amen? It isn't what I've heard people sometimes say, greasy grace. There's no such thing. Yes, it's by grace that you are saved. But some people act like it's just a bunch of grease and you don't have to do nothing. That's not true. Romans 12, 1 and 2. We all know this. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Amen. What did you come expecting this morning when you came to church? What was you expecting? Only you can answer that individually. I'm sure you came here expecting something. And who is the only one that can offer and actually fulfill what you came expecting? I can't. But Jesus can. Amen. So what are we supposed to put off? You know, the Bible tells us there are certain things we're supposed to put off. And there are things we're supposed to put on. And if you put your clothes on, you don't grow into them, right? When you put your clothes on, you put them on. When you take them off, you take them off. It isn't this process. That's why a new believer, you know, can be righteous. Because they can go on what they know. Is a baby going to know how to do what dad does? Or no more? No. So, Lord has higher expectations as we go along. Amen. He doesn't have the same expectation for me as maybe he does for you. Maybe he expects more from me than he expects from you. That's his prerogative of where we are right here at this moment. Amen. He tells us to put off malice. So what is malice? Well, one definition is ill will towards someone else for no reason. You ever hear of anybody doing that? Guile. Assuming something that is false to be true. Evil speaking. Do we ever evil speak about somebody? No, those things are supposed to be subtracted. Get rid of that. Get rid of it. What do we put on? Diligence, for one. What does diligence mean? Diligence, another meaning is haste. So you do it quickly. Amen? You don't wait. If the Lord says do something, do it then. Because what happens if you wait? Usually you don't do it. Cowards are going to be the first one in hell. He says we are not to be cowards. We're to be bold as lions. about sharing our faith, whether or not somebody likes it. And that's, I believe, why we are where we are. Because nobody stood up as these things came down in our government and different things. And I'm just looking at things from where we are right now. Are people standing up? I don't know. Does God have a good plan? Yes. But the plan's not over yet. And the fields are ready for harvest. And none of this can be done without the help of the Holy Spirit. And His name is holy. He can't stand any dirt. He can't stand any sin in our lives. Sometimes we'll tolerate sin. He says, no, no, no. So when we repent, which he said in the first few chapters of Revelation, seven different times, he wasn't talking to anybody but the church at that point. Repent, repent, repent. And what does repentance do? It helps us to be pure. But purity is not the end. Maturity is the end. Amen? But without purity, you're not going to become mature. Satan wants the saints to quit. That is his job, right? That's what he's been trying to do forever, or whenever he was created, or whenever Adam and Eve fell. He still uses the same tactics. He has not changed. Praise God, Jesus Christ hasn't changed either. Hallelujah. Amen. The godly must cling together. Are we clinging together? Only each individual can answer that. That's why he calls us a peculiar people, because we'll love, we'll forgive, we'll move forward when we fall down. If we've sinned against someone, we need to own up to it. And then move forward. Not keep thinking about it. So we need to strive with all diligence. And again, this is an urgency. And I haven't even got through the first page yet. And it's almost time. There's so much that the Lord has for us. We've only begun to hit a little bit. It's like an iceberg. A little bit up on top, but most of us down underneath where you can't see. And the Lord is stirring hearts. He is lighting a fire in people. But we have to Eat up the word. How do you eat the word? You get in it and you read it. How much of the word are we reading? How much of the word are we consuming? I can't say. All I can say is what I'm doing. That's all I'm supposed to know. But I know that the more word that we eat, the better it is for us. That doesn't necessarily mean that you won't have trouble. But if you eat His word, you're guaranteed you're going to have trouble. You're guaranteed that you're going to be rejected. And sometimes you'll be rejected by people you would never think you would be. You know, I think this was about the only thing the Lord hated was sin. And my prayer is that each and every one of us would hate sin like the Lord does. That we would get an upset stomach whenever we even think about doing something that would be sin, that we'd throw up. Because we are in a struggle between the new two natures, the old nature, new nature. The old nature wins out a lot. But he shouldn't. He shouldn't be starved. He shouldn't have anything to eat. But that means you may have to get rid of something, quit watching something, quit reading something. There's a lot of practical things to following Christ. He makes us righteous in the beginning. He keeps us righteous, and He'll get us to where we're going. Amen. There's a new heaven and a new earth. I don't claim to understand that, other than there will not be any sin, there will not be any tears, there will not be any sickness, there will not be any of those things. So we know we're not there. Amen. But one of these days we'll be in this place that He has for us. And we're going to see Him face to face. Hallelujah. So, again, repetitively, we have to kill those shoots and the old stone. They have to be dealt with every day. They have to be dealt with sometimes every moment. And thank you that we have Jesus, the Father, and the Holy Spirit that lives right here in us. He's a gentleman. He'll let us do some things sometimes. But He don't ever let us get away with anything. Amen. He is a disciplining Father. He's a good, good Father. Oh, Lord, thank you. Just ask that you touch hearts however you want to, and that someone would be able to come to faith in you today. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jim. I'm going to ask if we could sing a hymn before we leave. And if you take a hymnal book and just open up to page 2. You know, Jim, you said something I've heard a billion times, Holy Spirit, but His name is holy. I go, oh, it's not Holy Spirit, His name is holy. Never, it's just like, bing. And so Jesus, he says to the disciples, when you pray, pray like this. Father in heaven, holy is your name, holy is your name. So let's sing number 2 together, holy, holy, holy. Number 2, if you have a, there's one right in front of you, Mike. So we could go, holy, 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 Lord God. Merciful and